So welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett, and today we're going to take a look at licensing in XenDesktop 5. As always, you can follow these videos on the Urban Penguin, and you're able to follow me on Twitter at the Urban Penguin and on Facebook, the Urban Penguin. If you're interested in the Citrix Access Gateway, there is a book now available that I've authored, The Access Gateway Essentials, and that's available from Pact Pub or other online resellers. XenDesktop licensing is very similar to XenApp in the fact that we need a license server. So we can utilize the same license server as XenApp if we use both products, or we can have one just for XenDesktop. In the course, we're going to use 11.10, 1110, which is one of the latest versions of the licensing server. It can be a virtual appliance, or it can be software installed onto 2003 to Windows 7. Usually you expect this to be a server product, so probably installing onto your 2008 servers. The licensing server ports. So 27,000 is the main licensing port, and the desktop controllers connect on startup to check the availability of licensing. 8082 is the web console, so we as administrators connect to that port to manage the license server. And then user or device licenses are checked out on port 7279. Our licenses can be downloaded from mycitrix.com. They're allocated to the license server, to the host name of the license server, which is case sensitive. And we import them in the web console. Remember, that's port 8082. And XenDesktop can use concurrent or per user licensing models. So connecting to my license server on port 8082 for the console, we can see the licenses that are available. I don't currently have any XenDesktop. So I've logged onto my Citrix and I've downloaded the licenses for XenDesktop. So if we move into administration, and then log in as our admin user, and we can navigate to vendor, daemon configuration, and then import the new license. That appears OK. I can move down to Citrix here. We can reread the license files. And now when I look at the dashboard, we can see now that we have the XenDesktop licenses. And of course, we're ready to start installing the rest of our XenDesktop product.